Welcome to the Smoke Learning Channel. This set of videos focus on tracking. The previous video looked at tracking a paint stroke to a background. Now let's look at masks and track a set of masks to an image. This can certainly speed up the rotoscoping process for every artist. If you would like to follow along, please click the link in the YouTube description to download the media. If you are watching the podcast version of this video, then type the link displayed in your internet browser. For this example, we will track the paintwork on the car and grade it. We will then invert the mask and grade the rest of the image. Select the segment in the sequence and create a connect effects. Press one left arrow to hide the media panel. In the connect effects node bin, press G and drag out a Gmask node. Drop it into the connection and double-click on it for its controls. Now in the interests of time, press the load button under the Gmask heading. Navigate to the folder containing the downloaded media for these exercises. Here you will find a mask object track file. Select the file and it will load itself into the Gmask node. As you can see, I have already cut out the bodywork of the car. Hover over the result view and press F1 to see the masks over the image. Scrubbing the time bar, the first frame is lined up, but everything else is not. So we need to track all these masks to the body of the car. To visually understand this better, we need to look at the Gmask schematic. Select the Gmask node in the ConnectFX schematic and press Escape. A Geom node represents each mask and an Axis node control for each mask's transformation. This is almost identical to the Action 3D compositor. So it would be great if we could track the car once and apply the tracking data to all the masks. We will do this using another Axis node. Go to the object header and change the pull-down menu from Geom to Axis. Click the Add button. So with this new axis, hold Shift and kiss all the other axis nodes in the schematic. This will make the new axis the parent of all the masks and their respective axis nodes. Bearing that in mind, the top axis will contain all the tracking information. Make sure the top axis is selected. Go to the stabilizer tools on the left of the UI and not the right. These buttons are for object tracking for axis nodes. The other stabilizer button is for control point tracking on a mask's shape. Now we want to track position, rotation, and scale. So ensure all these options are set to on. There is another option for you to consider. This is called the Adjust option. In this pull-down menu, there are three options. Adjust Offset is used to reposition a mask's geometry if it is only attached to one axis. However, our masks are attached to a hierarchy of axis nodes. So Adjust Axis will offset all the children axis nodes so that the mask geometry stays in place when the track is applied to the top parent axis. This is the setting we will use. With the top axis selected, click the stabilizer button. Position the first tracker box to the left of the grill and position the second tracker box to the right of the grill. Press Analyze to do the track. This should be fairly straightforward, and you can exit the stabilizer when the track is done. Now scrubbing the time bar, you will see that the masks are in the right position and sticking to the car. Remember, if Adjust Axis was not enabled before going into the stabilizer, you would have to manually offset the masks to get them back into their intended positions. Hover over the result viewer and press F4 to see the mask result. So that's the masked bodywork of the car. Let's do some quick grading. Click the Effects Node button. In the ConnectFX node bin, drag out a Color Warper node. Connect the car media as the front and back inputs. Now connect the Gmask output as the matte input for the color warper node. Double-click on the color warper node for its controls. Change the trackball pull-down menu to the gamma curve. Select the blue channel button. Drag the middle control point of the curve to the right to lessen the blue in the car paintwork. You could also increase the saturation to make the color really stand out. Now let's invert the mask and grade the rest of the image. Switch back to the Connect Effects node bin. Press N for the negative node and drag it out. Connect the output of the Gmask node into the input of the negative node. Now drag another color warper out of the Connect Effects node bin. Connect the output of the first color warper as the front and back inputs. Take the output of the negative node and connect that into the matte input of the second color warper. Going into the second color warper, we can drop the black levels, pump up the white levels, and decrease the saturation. So we have gone from the original to this. Just ensure the output of the second color warper is connected to the CFX output node. Exit Connect Effects and press Render. Obviously, mask tracking can be used to cut things out or isolate a portion of the image for grading. But the main point is that wherever you use the masking tools, whether in Action, Modular Kia, or standalone mask node, the workflow will be the same. Here is the final result playing back. For our next example, we stay with masks, but go more granular and look at mask control point tracking. Thank you for watching, and please subscribe to the Smoke Learning channel for future videos.